Hello, everyone. My name is Gary. I'm one of the pastors at Living Water Community Church, and together with Pastor Jason, I've been asked to walk with you through this evening, through this time of gathering, to remember Dan, to tell stories, to share memories, and to support one another. It's times like these where we find out how much we rely on each other and how much supporting one another is essential. As we do that, if you're comfortable with it, would you bow your heads and pray with me? God, I ask you to come through on your promise. Your promise of being with us even to the very end of the age. I ask you to be with us tonight. When our strength isn't enough, I ask you to hold us up. I ask you to give a shoulder to lean on, to give an arm to wrap around us. Of course, we're all weary. God, of course we are all weak. This has been a tough season. 2020 has been an uphill battle, and we acknowledge that in Dan's passing, we have a lot of different emotions, a lot of different feelings, a lot of different thoughts. God, some are angry, some are sad, some are frustrated. Some are broken, some are tired. Some of us are simply putting one foot in front of the other. My prayer then for each of us, no matter where we are on that spectrum, is that you would understand us. We're coming to you with whatever we have, God, with however our day, our week, our year has been. We ask you to be God. Don't leave us. Don't forget your promises. Don't forget who you are, so that we can know who we are. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. One of the things about music is that it expresses emotion well. It tells a story. And one of the songs that has been chosen to express those thoughts and emotions is Oh, Danny Boy. And so let's sit and listen as this song plays. And as we reflect on these words, as we reflect on the thoughts, the emotions, the memories, Jason is going to come up after and share a few words. Let's listen to this song together. until as dead I well may be. You'll come find the place where I am lying, and you can say that I'll be there for me. I shall hear those songs you trap of me, and all my grief will warm sweetly. For you will bend and tell me that you love me. I shall see you until you come to me, and I shall see you until you come to me, and I shall see you until you
crazy, sad song that is. And how powerful those words are. The grief and the mourning that just pours through those. The ones that strike me are that it's hard to watch our loved ones go and to be the ones that have to abide. It's hard to stay when those that we care for have gone ahead of us. I also want to tell you that it's only natural to grieve, and that the grief that you feel, the grief that we experience, is a sign of the love that you have. Times to come, and all of the events that we'll miss. It's hard to think about the words that we haven't said, or the way we wish we might have done things differently. In the moment, it can even be tough to look back and to remember. But there's also healing in that. And it's good to look back and to hold on to those times of laughter, and those times of joy, those times that point out just what a gift Dan has been in your life. I'm sure that you all have your own memories and your own things that come to mind first, and those things that you hang on to, those things that will just always be there when you think of Dan. For me, I remember him at Cub Scout meetings, and I remember watching him blow out a ball glove and playing catch with people in the park. I remember him carting Girl Scout cookies around. I remember him giving up his time on Thanksgiving to serve others in the community and to provide them with meals. The first thing that came to mind for me was a phone call that I got from Dan and Nichole on Christmas Day a few years ago. They were having a discussion about whether or not Jesus was really born on Christmas. And they weren't coming to any resolution in that, and so they decided to call and to ask. I think Nichole was a little disappointed that I
I halfway agreed with him. Because
there's a chance,
but we don't know.
I always enjoyed the conversations I got to have.
He was not afraid to disagree with you.
But he also was willing to stop and to listen. He was willing to have the conversation with you. He was willing to have a debate and a discussion, but to do it in a way that was respectful. And I appreciated that. And I enjoyed that and the sarcasm that he would bring into it. The humor that he had. The memories are good, and they're important. And I hope that you've had time as you sit around the table and you have conversations to tell your stories to one another. And I hope that as you have time in these coming days that you can share your memories with each other and go back and relive those. Because the happy times are important. Stories that they aren't all easy memories, and that for Dan life wasn't always simple. He had his struggles against darkness. He had his demons that he wrestled with. He had his moments where he felt like he was at the end of himself and out of options. And if we're honest, I think we can all identify with that. I think it's easy for all of us to go down that road and to fight some of those same demons and to wrestle with some of those same emotions. Some words that bring me comfort in those moments and that I want to offer to you today as well is that the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. And it's times like this when our hearts are breaking that we need to hear that. And it's in those moments when we feel like our spirits are being crushed that we need those promises too. I think if I have one thing to offer you tonight, it's that when you feel crushed, when the grief is a struggle in these days to come, when it feels like your heart is breaking again, that you know that you don't have to go through these moments alone. That you know that God walks alongside us and is near to us as our hearts are breaking. And that he rescues us when it feels like we're being crushed. There are two signs that the family chose for tonight. And both of them so incredibly fitting and appropriate. The second one is Angels Among Us by Alabama. We'll listen to that in just a second, but Pastor Gary, if I could pray for you. God, first of all, we give you thanks for Dan. We give you thanks for everything in him that was good, everything in him that was kind, for all the ways that we were able to see the love that he had for his family, for his friends. We give you thanks for the gift of his life. Lord, as we gather together this evening,
as we feel that ache, as we grieve and we mourn, God, I pray that you would be in this place. I pray that you would give your strength to this family. I pray that they would know the hope that you offer them, the peace that you have for them. God, it's difficult to go through a loss, and especially when it's something unexpected. Lord, when our strength fails, I pray that you would give us your strength. When we're at the end of ourselves, I pray that we would find that you continue to carry us through these moments. Lord, in those moments when we struggle, I pray that you would help us to find comfort in you, to find strength in one another. Lord, help us to go forward from this moment with a sense of hope for tomorrow. Lord, as we listen to this song, I pray that you would encourage and bless this family. I pray that as they hear the song about your angels, your messengers present among us, Lord, I pray that you would send people into their days that would encourage them and support them and help them through these next days and weeks. Lord, I pray that you would surround them with your angels. We pray all this in your name, and we trust this to you. Amen.
Kind of funny at the dark end of the road.
Of course, the season of Christmas is never going to be the same. It's a very, very difficult time to lose a family member, to lose a loved one. But my hope is that this takes on a deeper meaning for you. In a lot of ways, it becomes even more of an understanding of what Christmas is. Because for some reason, grief causes us to look at things from a different angle. It causes us to look at priorities. In fact, there's a story from Scripture that tells about Jesus' birth, a well-known version. It's in Charlie Brown's Christmas, for crying out loud. It's, in those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree. It's what sparks debates about what day it's actually on. But I'm usually more of a fan of give me the bullet points. Give me the main theme. So I've always liked another book of the Bible's angle on Jesus' birth. In the book of John, the author tells the Christmas story this way. The Word, that is Jesus, became flesh and made his living among us. Period. The Word became flesh. That's to the point. That's not a lot of details. That's not where everyone was in the story. But it carries a lot of meaning. Because that word, flesh, the Word became flesh, that carries in the original translation a meaning of fleshy, of carnal, of basic, of dirty. Jesus got in the dirt. He got in the mud. He got in our grit. He got in our grime. He got in our yucky world. He didn't come to hang out with kings and queens. He didn't come to hang out with people who have their emotions all together and have everything figured out. He came to hang out, as Jason said, with those who have emotions all over the place. He came to hang out with us. We just sang Angels Among Us, and it's wonderful to know that his servants, that his angels are around. But I think even cooler than that, even more impressive than that, is that he is around. He cries with us when we cry. He smiles with us when we smile. He understands when we're mad. He understands when we're frustrated. He listens even when we yell. I think we can go from here knowing that this Christmas season especially reminds us that we are not alone. God is with us, and he will be with us, even to the very end of the age. And so may that God of all grace, even after you suffer for a little while, may he restore you. May he make you strong and firm and steadfast. And to him be the glory and the power forever and ever. Amen. Amen. If you stay seated for just a moment, Chad will come and give us direction on where to go next.